Good morning, children. Today we shall discuss the second part of the chapter, political organization. As we were studying about Panchayati Raj, so today we are going to discuss the three-tier system of Panchayat. Panchayat works at three levels. The first level is village level, which is called Gram Panchayat. Second level is called block level, which is called Panchayat Samiti. And the third level is the district level, or we call it Zilla Parishad. Let us begin with Gram Panchayat, means village level. Gram Panchayat is a local self-government institution at the village or small town level in India. It has a sarpanch as its elected head. A Gram Panchayat consists of 7 to 17 members elected from the ward of the village, and they are called the panch. 1/3 of the seats are reserved for female candidates. To establish a Gram Panchayat in a village, the population of that village must be at least 500 people of voting age. The main source of Gram Panchayat is the property tax levied on buildings and open spaces within the village. There are other sources of income also. They include professional taxes, taxes on pilgrimage, if there is any in the village, then animal trade. Next, maybe the grant received from the state government in proportion of land revenue, and the grants which are received from the District Council of India, means Zilla Parishad. Then in Gram Panchayat, there is a Gram Sevak. This Gram Sevak is also called Gram Vikas Officer, and he is the communicator in government and village panchayats and works for the sarpanch. Next comes the second level, block level, means Panchayat Samiti. Panchayat Samiti is a local government body at the tehsil level, means a combination of many small villages. It works for the villages of tehsil that together are called a development block. The Panchayat Samiti is a link between the Gram Panchayat, village, that is also called village council, and the Zilla Parishad, means district board. A Panchayat Samiti is composed of elected members of the area and the block development officer, which is called BDO. Otherwise, unrepresented members associate members of that panchayat block on the Zilla Parishad. The Samiti, means Panchayat Samiti, is elected for 5 years and it is headed by a chairman and a deputy chairman elected by the members of the Panchayat Samiti. Panchayat Samiti collects all the prospective plans prepared at Gram Panchayat level and then process them for funding and implementation by evaluating them from the angles of financial constraints. Then third level comes, and that is called the district level or Zilla Parishad. District Council or Zilla Parishad is the third tier of the Panchayat system. It is an elected body. Chairpersons or block pramukhs of block samitis are also represented in Zilla Parishad. Councillors chosen by direct election from electoral divisions in the district and the chairman of all the panchayat samitis form the members of Zilla Parishad. The chief executive officer means CEO, who is an IAS or a state civil service officer, heads the administrative machinery of Zilla Parishad. This person may also be the district magistrate. So this is all about the three levels or the three tier system of panchayat. These panchayats have been very beneficial for women. As we know that gender issue is mainly being addressed in Indian society. In India, villages society is predominated by prohibitions and taboos against women. To deal with all these, panchayats are constituted in a manner that ensure women's representation to give them a voice in the society. So now we are going to discuss the role of panchayats in the empowerment of women. The panchayats have empowered women in the following ways. The 73rd Constitution Amendment Act has made an effort to give some special powers to women in all three tiers of Panchayati Raj. With that, women have acquired some improvement in their social and economic life, and they can take part in decision-making activities too. Women have been empowered through liberation from social, legal and political restrictions. Education, communication, media, political parties and general awakening through Panchayati Raj efforts. So when a woman gets a place in the society, she becomes powerful in the family also. The 73rd and 74th amendments to the constitution ensured the reservation of 1/3 of the total seats for women in the elected offices of local bodies in both rural as well as urban areas, which has bestowed them with decision-making powers. They have gained more power and confidence by asserting control over resources. Their presence in these local government offices has given many women a greater understanding of the working of politics. Women are being experienced and at the same time they are becoming more decisive and they are becoming more confident. In many cases, we have seen that the women were guided and thoroughly influenced by their husband or other members of their families while deciding public matters, which give them an experience and also confidence. So we have seen these points which are showing the role of panchayats in the empowerment of women. Now there is another term which is called Bal Panchayat. Bal Panchayat means a parliament for children. So let us understand what are these Bal Panchayats. Bal Panchayats means Children Parliament is an initiative which is supported by UNICEF, has been adopted by some panchayats in different parts of India to encourage the involvement of children in self-governance for their own development through creative projects, consultations and community programs. Children learn about their human rights while acquiring knowledge, skill, behavior and values for citizenship. So all these things connect the children with each other, with their adults and with their communities. And also they get connected with policy makers under the guidance of neighborhood community network. So what is the purpose of creating Bal Panchayats or Children Parliament? It has some aims. Like the Bal Panchayats aim to reduce the school dropout rate. Then they achieve 100% literacy. Because these Bal Panchayats do lot of labor to bring the children back to school. Then Bal Panchayats wean away social evils such as child marriages, female infanticide, feticides, and then they assure availability of basic amenities. Which basic amenities? Like protected drinking water, sanitary facilities and other problems. These children who become the members of the Bal Panchayats, they draw the attention of their seniors or adults towards the problems which are being faced by the children in that local area. So something can be done. For example, if there is no school, then the provisions are made to start a new school for the children, or many other problems can be solved through Bal Panchayats. There are many examples. These Bal Panchayats are working in many states of India. Like there is Mekkala Panchayat in Karnataka. This Mekkala Panchayat conceived as a parallel government of children working closely with village council. It was introduced in 1995 as a leading project by the NGO concern for working children, school going children and children with disabilities and so on. Another example is Bhim Sangh Children Union. So this Bhim Sangh Children Union and the Mekkala Panchayats are playing proactive roles as change agents in the community. The ultimate goal of this program is to develop a mechanism for establishing accountability of elected representatives to the children of their communities and to affirm the right of children to participate in decision making processes. Then in Rajasthan, there are 30 Bal Panchayats are functioning in Ajmer district only. Rajasthan has dismal record on the gender front. More importance is given to the male members or to the boys, and there is no place for the girls. According to UNICEF, 82% of the girls in the state are married by the age of 15. The child sex ratio is also loaded against the girl child, and it is being reduced from 1901 to 2001 census. Thus, involvement of children through different activities can help local people to be more aware to take actions to eradicate these social problems. Then there is a village called Shimoga in Karnataka. So study done on schools in a village, means Shimoga, noted that community participation ensures better prospect for child education. And financial contribution by the community is providing new assets to the school is a step taken to improve the condition of local school. So we have seen that it is also a very good scheme supported by UNICEF in order to uplift the standard of children, to bring 100% literacy and to remove many kind of practices which were prevailing in India.